Hello good people, Ibar here with Hardware Canucks, and yes, I do sound sick. That's because unfortunately I did catch the CES flu and I'm slowly recovering from it. But anyways, coming back to the topic, back at CES, AMD announced their third generation Ryzen processors along with their Radeon 7 graphics card, which is a really interesting GPU for the price, so I really can't wait to test that out and give you guys my verdict on it. Definitely stay tuned for that video very soon. But we spent a good amount of time talking to AMD and their board partners regarding these new CPUs. And it was actually pretty interesting because, Gen 3 Ryzen CPUs have a lot of people talking about where AMD is going this year and how much their processors have changed within the short amount of time. So everyone is excited about it, and I think you should be as well. So why don't we talk about that right after this.
Evolve with the times. Consider NVMe storage today. The new RC100 brings affordable NVMe storage into your hands with various capacities in this super compact form factor that plugs directly into your motherboard. It's extremely power efficient and utilizes Toshiba's advanced 3D flash memory for awesome speeds so you can be a happy user. The RC100 by Toshiba, the NVMe drive to consider. Check it out below.
Now, you guys might recall that when I covered the AMD Ryzen 7 2700X and the Ryzen 5 2600X, I was actually super impressed by what they brought to the table. Not only that, but Intel really didn't have an answer since their CPUs were just far too expensive by comparison. But now, we're actually gonna start to see third generation Ryzen CPUs hitting sometime this summer. Now, before I get too far into this video, it's super important to understand what these new processors are made of. Basically, the first generation Ryzen used Zen, whereas the 2700X and other second generation processors used the Zen Plus design, which refined the original Zen architecture. Meanwhile, what I'm talking about in this video is the third generation Ryzen CPUs, which are based off the Zen 2 architecture and AMD's new 7nm manufacturing process. That 7nm node should actually allow them to pull ahead of Intel for the very first time in almost a decade. Basically, Intel has been stuck with an endless number of Skylake refreshes, and as they wait for the 10nm ramp up and Ice Lake, while AMD has sprinted ahead. That poses a problem for Intel since Ice Lake won't be ready until the end of 2019 at the earliest, while AMD's Ryzen 3000 series will be shipping in volume to customers this summer, which is awesome. Part of the reason why AMD has been able to move so quickly to the 7nm node is how they're designing their processors. Instead of a single large complicated die that holds the CPU cores, memory controllers, the I/O stages, and other elements, they've broken things off into multiple smaller sections so they're easier to manufacture. Yields can also increase this way. In the case of Ryzen 3, up to 8 x86 cores are housed on a smaller 7nm die, while the I/O gets pushed off into a separate section. This approach can actually be scaled upwards to create processors with even more cores for Threadripper and Epic families. But that's not exactly what makes Ryzen 3 so exciting. What AMD showed at their press conference was a very early 8-core 16-thread chip running equal to an Intel 9900K at stock settings in Cinebench. Based on our own tests, that would make the 3000 series chip roughly 15% faster than the previous generation. Not only that, but its system was consuming just 133 watts versus the 9900K's 180 watts. Remember, this is with relatively early silicon, which means it isn't running the final frequencies. If AMD is able to further improve clock speeds before launch, we may see their third generation Ryzen products easily overcome the current Coffee Lake CPUs. And unless Intel can bake some serious performance improvements into their Ice Lake architecture, even that may have a tough time with Zen 2. This is a huge deal, guys, but remember, AMD needs to improve their lightly threaded performance if they have any hope of beating Intel across the board. Games in particular tend to fall into Intel's camp since their architecture excels when it's operating at lower thread counts. Supposedly, a lot of Zen 2's internal revisions are focused on bridging this gap, so let's hope that's true. Not only is AMD promising third-gen Ryzen processors will be the best for performance and efficiency, but they'll also be technically compatible with all AM4 motherboards. I'm saying technically because motherboard manufacturers have to release a proper BIOS for that kind of support, and everyone we've talked to is planning to do exactly that. While this sounds like a cool feature, there will be some limitations with backwards compatibility. Certain overclocking options may be disabled and memory support might be cut down a bit. The third gen Ryzen processors will also support PCI Express 4.0, which isn't a big deal right now, but it could be pretty important for future NVMe storage devices and GPUs. Originally, we thought this feature would be exclusive to the new 500 series motherboards, but after talking to a few reps at CES, it turns out older generation 300 and 400 series will be compatible with PCIe 4.02. The reason for this is pretty simple. Physically and electrically, the PCIe 3.0 and 4.0 slots are exactly the same. The only difference is the 4.0 standard has a faster signaling rate. Because of the increased signaling requirements, traces on the motherboard can't exceed 6 inches before additional components are needed to drive PCI Express 4.0's higher bandwidth. Since older motherboards weren't built with those components, only the first X16 PCI slots would possibly receive access to the 4.0 standard. That's a big if too, because backwards compatibility in this case would require substantial BIOS work. It's still gonna be interesting to see if any company actually does it though. Now, I'm not sure how many people will actually take advantage of all this backwards compatibility, but at least AMD is giving people the option. Intel really needs to take some lessons here because I'm pretty tired of buying a new motherboard with almost every one of their small CPU revisions. The last thing that I wanna mention is overclocking. Now, AMD hasn't published any numbers as of right now, but from our conversations with every motherboard manufacturer, they are planning on launching some extreme products for the AM4 platform. So that means expect extreme line of motherboards for the Ryzen platform. And this also means that there could potentially be a good clock speed headroom with the third generation Ryzen CPUs, which is very exciting.
For our Canadian audience, Memory Express is a place to go for home, business, and gaming electronics. You can try before you buy, especially great for peripherals, by visiting one of their stores in Winnipeg, Calgary, or Greater Vancouver, and more. They do custom PCs and will beat any Canadian price, guaranteed.
So there you guys have it. Right now, we still don't know all that much about third generation Ryzen processors, but even at this early point, I'm very excited about what AMD has to offer for the rest of 2019. In fact, this is probably the first in a lot of years that I feel like almost Intel is far behind at what AMD is achieving. Competition is always good, but if AMD can actually pull ahead of what Intel can achieve, it's going to be an interesting year. It's going to be an interesting rest of 2019, so I'm looking forward to that. Anyways, let me know what you guys think about the upcoming third generation Ryzen processors. Are you satisfied with your current setup? And if you're not, would you actually consider upgrading to the third generation Ryzen CPUs? Also, if you're on an existing X370 or X470 motherboard, would you consider upgrading to the new processors along with a new motherboard? I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments down below. I'm Ibar with Hardware Canucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe to our new boot sequence channel. I'm signing off, and I'll see you guys in the next one.